Valleys, welcome. Today we're focusing on healing sickness because I have been feeling pretty rough this past few days, and I just thought, okay, it's time to do some Reiki, some spell work to heal as physical sick bodies, because we are moving now through autumn into winter and we're starting to see a lot more bugs coming in and viruses, so I think it's time that we start getting ourselves protected and cleared up of any nasties. So I am still getting my voice back, but hopefully it will not sound too bad. So today we're going to heal this sick, achy, virusy bodies. We're doing some healing, we're bringing in some witchcraft, we're going to do some sigils. We're going to send out some Reiki healing, and we're going to slow down and get ourselves into a really nice relaxed state so that our bodies can heal and further protect itself from getting any additional symptoms. Do your best to get comfortable in this moment and allow me to take you on a soothing, pain relief, symptom relief journey. We will be inviting in some of our angelic support today to help us along this healing. It's really about giving ourselves what we need in this moment, and sometimes rest and release is exactly what we need to be doing. So let's begin with just finding a still, peaceful moment. Firstly, just recognizing the feelings that are going on for you in your body right now. And just accepting that we are where we are. We're feeling how we're feeling. Knowing that it's okay to be sick sometimes, knowing that it's okay to slow down, to take this time off to rest, that it's okay, you don't need to go anywhere, and we know that we're safe, and that we're protected, knowing that you are loved. And as we just do our very best to take a deep breath, and if you're like me and you're coming off the back of a cold or a flu and your nostrils are still a little bunged up, then it's okay to breathe through your mouth. And if you are blessed with the freedom of nostril breathing, then go ahead and take a deep breath in through your nose. And we're just filling up the body with lots of light today. Allowing the body to just expand into the light. inviting in the warmth of the sun goddess and the beauty of the light, the angelic forces, as we welcome in the light into the chest, purified, and as we breathe in the light, we breathe in the healing, we breathe in relaxation, we breathe in health and wellness, and our intention today is to feel well, to accept and let go of the need to do anything but heal. So I'm going to just place some Reiki symbols over you before we begin our sigil and element healing. That's just so that you can receive some. If you want to close your eyes, then you can keep them open. That's okay. This is your space. Draw the symbols for you today using this clear quartz. Your body now responds to the healing symbols. We're going to invite in our beloved angels, the forces of divine healing, as we invite in the gods and the goddesses. We request the presence of the angelic beings, spirits, ancestors, healers of past, present and future, to combine their powerful energy and surround us with protection and light and love. We call upon the forces to deliver the violet fire and the essence of divine Reiki energy darling. I'm going to bring in some of our crystals. Just to soothe those particularly stubborn areas that are causing you most discomfort at the minute. I have definitely found that my head and throat have been particularly affected by this latest little virus, so if you're experiencing those too, this should help take away a little bit of that discomfort. Okay. So I'm just going to start really gently with the crown of your head. I'm just going to take some selenite and just gently sweep that down so that we can clear out any stagnant energy and all that stuffy mucousy sickness. Just bring that down across the forehead and just bringing it down around the sides of your face. Just gonna take that now down. There we go, down, down, just bring it. Pull things through. So next we've got some lapis lazuli, and this is going to be really helpful for your throat, so I'm just going to hold that there for a moment, just above your throat. And just sending out the power. Clearing up any sore throat energy, any stiffness, coughs. It's also really good for breathing. And I'm just going to place that down there, just underneath you, so that will radiate up through your chest. And again, bringing in our clear quartz, just add some light to those upper chakras. And we're also going to take it down, 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 down. Go down. Wonderful. And again, just placing that underneath. And then we've got one of my favourite stones, which is a malachite crystal. A little bit stripey. This is really, really good for clearing out negative energies and giving us some clarity, which again I think especially when we're not feeling as best we struggle with. I definitely do. My thinking has been all over the place this week after I think I really struggled with rest and hey, you know, we're all still human, or at least half human. Sometimes we need a little bit of help to get back on his feet and taking that balance between being comforted but also kind of pushing yourself through can be quite a thing to get right. Lastly, we're just going to bring in some carnelian, which is going to be really, really good to soothe any stomach problems, any complaints. So we've got, especially when we've like brought all this stuff down into the body, and it's just nestled in to the gut. So we want to carry that down. I'm just going to place that right at your base, so that will take care of all those nasties that have been gathering up in your lower chakras. Okay, we are feeling open and we are feeling relaxed. Now, it's time to take it to the elements. Okay. I'm now going to call in our elements to assist us in this healing process. Got my trusty tools, which you can't see right now, but that's okay. Okay. And as we call upon the elements of air, and its powers to move and shift, we call upon the element of air to deliver freshness, oxygen that we require. We call upon all the properties of movement and renewal and refreshing. Bliss. We thank the air for its presence in allowing us to breathe, and for this challenge that we're experiencing in sickness to really dig into gratitude for those moments where we are well. And we call upon the element of fire for allowing us to experience heat, warmth, comfort, and for the incredible power that it possesses. The light where there is darkness, heat where there is cold. We thank you, element of fire. And we ask for you to assist in the burning away of this sickness so that we may be restored to full health. And as we move to the element of water, our tribute is our beautiful piece of sea coral, which is shaped by your very oceans. And we thank you, element of water, for your continued life giving substance, for the rains that fall, for the dew in the morning grass, for the water that we in fact are in our own bodies, for the ability to clean and consume you. for all life that you have created on earth. We thank you, element of water. And finally, element of earth, we ask for your divine presence. We thank you for the ground that we walk on, for the ability to ground ourselves. We thank you for allowing us to build homes and life down here on this planet. And we thank you for your ever-growing and expanding natural world that we're able to live alongside. Thank you, element of earth. And as we call upon all elements of air, of fire, of water, and of earth, and forgetting not the power of spirit and presence. And we ask spirit to deliver us from all suffering and pain in this moment, but to leave us with the lessons and insight that we may carry forth to the rest of our day from this experience. Thank you. As we take the energy now and bring it in. This energy now and send it forth. We are healing, capturing the light of healing energy and sending it forth. We're feeling comforted. Healed by the light, soothed by the light. Your sickness is temporary, and you'll be feeling yourself again in no time. But you need to rest now. You need to rest. And allow yourself to feel accepted and loved by this experience. You're okay. You're okay. You're taken care of. We're going to create a couple of sigils and engrave them onto our candle so that we can burn all those negative little chatters away and replace it with just full health. So let's do our sigils. So I'm going to start off. I've created two sigils today for you. The first is really simple. I am healed. I'm gonna okay. And the next one we're doing is I sigils drawn for you before, but they are very powerful tools. These are an affirmation of types, but with a lot of action and intention attached. So we are going to apply these sigils now to our candle, and then we will be lighting the candle and allowing the sigils to take hold in this reality. I want you to sit with the intention now that you are healed, that you are healthy, this is a great opportunity now to really visualize yourself in a healed and healthy body. The important thing to remember again when we're looking at the words that we use is the ability to talk ourselves further into illness. And we can all do it. I've done it so many times, and I'll reaffirm that, oh, I'm feeling really ill, I'm really under the weather. But the more that we actually state that to the world, the more that becomes our reality. So I've found that a really good way of speaking to people when you're not feeling well is just to say, I'm not well, but I am healing, I am getting better. To really reinforce to yourself that you are getting better, that you are healthy, that you'll be over it in a couple of days, you'll be fine, I'm okay. I'm just taking a couple of days to rest while I recover from this illness. Because most of us, the majority of us, will really quickly recover from an illness, especially colds, flus, stomach bugs and things like that. So you will be fine. You are fine. You are healing, and it is really natural and normal to be healing. So let's just be with our sigils now. And as we incant the words, I am healed. I am healthy. I am healed. I am healthy. I am healing. I am healthy. This actually makes me feel so much better. Just to say those words out loud. And this is our finished sigil. So there's two sigils. And the top is I am healed, and underneath I am healthy. So as we burn through the candle, we will slowly make our way down. And you can do this yourself, and I really do recommend like creating sigils. If you don't know, Then you can ask. There are so many different videos that you can watch on sigil writing. There's a lot of, you know, great helpful books that you can get on sigil writing. But also you can just trust yourself. You know, you can write anything into one of your candles. Or you can write it on paper and just, you know, burn it safely. Sigils are a really great way of manifesting your intentions. So, let's light our candle. There we go. As we ask the power of the elements to infuse our intentions with the universe energy. And this is going to set us up for the most beautiful recovery. I'm just going to gently place some of our selenite at either side, and I'm going to keep this burning for a while for you so that the healing elements really nestle themselves into your being. I think it's really important to go at a pace when you're sick that feels best, and if you do struggle to rest and just take it easy, then, you know, also give yourself a break from judging. That's the most important thing. I find that's one of the easiest ways to rest for me, is to just not be hard on myself in my thinking, and that can sometimes be the hardest bit to do. Want to stay in bed, that's great, but if you also want to go out for a walk, that's okay too. Rest doesn't look the same for everybody, and you need to take the rest that's appropriate for you. Really loving, caring energy, and distributing that down, 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 down. Take as much as you need. We're feeling a bit more refreshed, yeah? Good. Good. Any time you can take to just rest and reconnect to your own needs, so you can slow down enough to recognize your thinking and what your body actually needs in these moments is always, always a great thing to do. You know, nothing's ever going to cure you overnight, and I think it's about recognising, like, just what small things can I do today that's really going to help me recover. Reiki is so powerful, but it won't just take everything away. Neither will a spell, but it does work alongside you and your intentions. And if your intention today is to heal, then it will support that. No. I hope you're feeling a lot more relaxed and peaceful and able to heal. Go and get yourself a nice soothing drink, either water or a nice hot tea. You can either climb into bed, take a seat. Maybe you want to go out for a walk. Just go and do something else that feels really easy. Don't be hard on yourself today, darling, okay? I'm going to let you continue your rest and recovery in peace. And remind you always that you are safe here, that you are loved and appreciated. And I'm sending you continued healing, continued love, continued support. I hope you feel better soon, darling.